Good evening, everyone, from Madison Square Garden here in New York. I'm Howard David, your host for the 41st National Invitational Basketball Tournament, featuring the Longhorns of Texas from the Southwest Conference and from the Atlantic Coast Conference, the Wolfpack of North Carolina State. The one-liners of Abe Lemons, the head coach of Texas, are kind of historic already in New York. Meanwhile, Norm Sloan can become the fifth coach in NCAA history to win both an NCAA and NIT title in his career. I'll be hosting your show, handling the play-by-play. Here's Don Crickey.
Thank you very much, Howard. I'm joined tonight by Bucky Waters, former head coach at West Virginia and Duke. We have two teams with contrasting styles. Carolina State's a big running team from the Atlantic Coast Conference. Texas is a relatively small team, but a very elusive one. Bucky, lead off. Tell us about Carolina State.
North Carolina State is really an extension of their coach, Norman Sloan. They're intense. He has pushed this young team beyond their fondest expectations. They are deep, they are young, they are quick, they are strong, and they play the transition game extremely well.
Texas coach Abe Lemons has gotten a lot of press here in New York with his interesting quips. He says he doesn't get anything from scouting reports because he doesn't read them, but he does have a very well-coached basketball team.
Yes, they are very deceptive. They are small, but they shoot the ball extremely well, and they're so smart. They put on a clinic here the other night and beat a fine Rutgers team. I understand that Texas is the favorite. It's hard to believe when you look at the athletes. It's going to be right down to the wire, probably a 1 or 2 point game, Don.
I will be back with the starting lineups in just a moment. We are just about set to go in this championship game of the 41st National Invitation Tournament from the capital of basketball, Madison Square Garden in New York. The North Carolina State Wolfpack comes in with a record of 21-9, led by their coach Norm Sloan, who has over 400 victories to his credit, as does his counterpart Abe Lemons, the head coach of Texas, a school that is going into basketball in a big way now, matching up with the great football program the Longhorns have. This season, Texas has already won 25 basketball games. And here are their starting lineups coming out now. This is a big power forward from Los Angeles. His name is Ron Baxter, 6'4". Looks a little overweight, but he can get up in the air, and he's a very elusive player. He'll be matched up against Heine Pinder of North Carolina State. He is a 6'8 junior from Miami, Florida. Now, from Placentia, California, comes Tyrone Brennan. He is the big elusive forward that scored 24 points the other night in a runaway victory over Rutgers. We gotta watch. Gary Goodner coming out now for the University of Texas. He is their center out of Denton, Texas. He'll be countered by Tom Sudoff. Hawkeye Whitney also, you saw coming out briefly a moment ago. He is another outstanding frontline player for the Carolina Wolfpack. And now we look at the backline players. Texas gets a lot of shooting. This might be the best player on their team of considering overall ability, John Moore, a backcourt player out of Altoona, Pennsylvania, 6'1". And here is the guy who threw in that miracle shot that carried North Carolina State over Georgetown, Clyde the Glide Austin from Richmond, Virginia. Here's the Texas Longhorns' best shooter from Southport, Indiana, Jim Prevax, averaging 21.5 points a game. And he's got a big guy across from him coming out for the Carolina Wolfpack, Tony Warren, a 6'6 backcourt player. We'll be back with the tip-off right after these messages from your local stations.
And the head coach of North Carolina State, Norm Sloan.
Keep saying Carolina.
There's a lot more to live.
The pivot man for the Texas Longhorns.
That guy could set a double pick right there. He's some kind of player.
Like getting around Wayne Embry.
You got to take your lunch.
There is Pinder at the free throw line for North Carolina State. He was a junior college player in Florida. 6'8", and he can move. So now we see that the Wolfpack under Norm Sloan is going to go right to the press, and a full court pass to Krivax gives the Texas Longhorns a second breakaway basket. They take a 4-1 lead, 4-2 lead.
North Carolina State is going to try to push the tempo. They're going to try to press all game, and they've got to live with that. But again, we pointed out that Texas is very deceptive. They don't look like they're going fast, but they are so smart.
Texas with that shifting zone. They play it very well. They'll overmatch. They'll get up on the ball and pressure it. Here is Hawkeye Whitney, the big power forward, unable to control the offensive board, but Carolina State has it. And now there's a turnover off the hands of Pinder, and so the ball comes back inbound to the Longhorns. Let's see if North Carolina State comes out of that full court press, because Texas has been eating it up.
North Carolina State is going to live with it. They play 10 players every game. The 10 that played in the semifinals, 9 scored. So they feel their bench is deep enough to sustain the pressure, even if they get burned early.
They're getting set to put Don Perkins into the game now. Here is a shot up. Brannion is no good. The rebound kicked around, and working hard is Baxter. And it led Dorsey High School in Los Angeles to the L.A. City Championship a few years ago, and he just works harder and gets the points for Texas. They lead 6-2.
They list him at 205, but look at the big guy go.
That bucket will go. Ron Baxter doing a big job for Texas. Let's watch him again.
He admits to 225 despite the program listing only 205. North Carolina State careless with that ball. The great quickness of the big guy. I believe he can go faster than that. He was begging for the three-point attempt, and he got it.
He handled that beautifully as it was a continuation play. He was in the act of going in for the shot when he drew the foul, then took it right through, and good ball control. He lays it in. So Texas now has been getting the layups in North Carolina State with 18:32 to play. In the first half, we have an 8-2 game.
Ron Baxter with that three-point, with his third point of the game, just went over 1,000. The ceremony then was simply to give him the game ball.
Sophomore player. And so now, with Baxter hitting the free throw, we have a 9-2 game as Texas moves out in front. They are a tough club. They got the big lead on Rutgers, and Rutgers could never come back in the semifinal game. Now Pinder lunging into the lane, puts up the high arcing jump shot, and North Carolina State is down 9-4. Again, they go down court. This time, John Moore. Oh, these guys can play basketball.
What a start. Texas throwing that ball the length of the court. I know the Southwest Conference is football country. They can relate to that. That's what you call a fly pattern, and they're putting it right on the money. That time the pass was a little bit underthrown, but John Moore, who is perhaps the best athlete on the team, made an incredible play to take it in. And again, another shot at a three-point play, and he converts.
So three times now, the Texas Longhorns have gone to the full court pass against the press, and three times they've beaten the North Carolina State defense, and Texas has opened up a 12-4 lead with less than 2 minutes gone by in the first half. With the ball is Tony Warren, goes inside to Pinder, but he's doubled up. And now, good defensive play by Tyrone Brannion. Gets the ball over to Krivax, and Texas comes down on the run. Home run ball. These guys are confident.
This is what you call blowing them out at the start. North Carolina State has to be patient. They know this is an explosive team, and they've got to rely on their bench and their depth to wear them down. Texas usually plays 6 guys at the most.
Ron Baxter drilling that long jump shot, and now he slaps the ball away from Sudop, the center for North Carolina State. And we're going to have a foul call on the play. Hank Nichols and Ed Gattata are our officials, and now Norm Sloan's going to his bench, getting some people in there. Matthews is coming in for the first time. Hawkeye Whitney coming back in the game. Jones coming in. Let's watch that again.
Clyde Austin making the penetration up in the air, just a little lob pass to Glenn Sudhop from behind. A good call. He nearly shoved that ball down on top of his head. Both of these are young teams, Don. Only Goodner of Texas is the only senior in the starting lineup for both teams, so the future bodes well.
They really are. North Carolina State wasn't expecting to have that much of a year, as you pointed out at the outset, but they came back with a big season, playoff season. Now, Carolina State continues to put the pressure on Texas, but Texas has had no problem breaking. They didn't even use the dribble to break it. It's those long passes. We have 17-20 to play in the first half, and Texas has opened up a 14-5 lead. John Moore pulls up, can't get it to go, but Brannion is under there, puts it up, gets it to go. No, the basket is disallowed. What do we have here?
Incredible. Texas cannot make a mistake.
We'll be back from Madison Square Garden in New York City. This is the 1978 NIT Basketball Championships.
lifting. All that weight makes me feel just great. Now's the time I find, got Blue Ribbon on my mind.
I've got Pabst Blue Ribbon on my mind. More and more lately I find I've got a taste for living. I'm thinking gold, Blue Ribbon. I've got Pabst Blue Ribbon on my mind.
Naturally good Pabst, a lot to look forward to.
I've been in the business for years, and this is one of the biggest improvements I've seen in air filters. Regular models have one filter. This Fram has two.
When an ordinary filter gets dirty, the Fram stays cleaner. In tests, it lasted 50% longer than our regular filter.
That's why it's called the Fram Extra Life. Why not change your old filter for this Fram? It doesn't cost any more, but it can save a lot later.
Fram and Autolite are Bendix companies.
Zonk, if you want a date, get in shape.
Shape? I'm solid steel.
Uh-uh. Chic shape, Zonk. Chic shape.
Get clean, get close, get comfort too. Get your face in chic shape.
Click in Chic Super 2, the only twin blades Teflon coated for incredibly comfortable close shaves.
Great shape, Zonk.
That's chic shape.
That's Super 2.
We are back at Madison Square Garden in New York. This is Don Kroeke with Bucky Waters courtside as we're set to go now with the 17-13 showing on the first half clock. Tyrone Brannion gets the ball out to the big guy, Ron Baxter. Texas is in the lead 14-5. They have really outsmarted North Carolina State so far, and Carolina State's coach Norm Sloan has gone to a new lineup almost. Craig Davis is in the game. Watts is in the game. Art Jones is in, and Kenny Matthews is in. None of them starters. Here is the ball to Matthews now, and little Craig Davis, who perhaps can get the running game going for North Carolina State, gets it over to the big power forward, Hawkeye Whitney. Here is Matthews moving into the lane, but the Texas defense shuts it down. And again, North Carolina State misplays the ball. And Texas so far, Bucky, is controlling the basketball game at both ends.
Just as they did in the semifinal Sunday night. Tom Young, the Rutgers coach, couldn't believe it. His team shot 58% in the first half, and they were down 6 at the half. And it's just that kind of start that we're seeing tonight by the Longhorns.
Here is Krivax, who is a long-range shooter but can't get that to go. Brannion working hard off the offensive board. We have a whistle underneath. It looks like Whitney might have been called for pushing. They're getting the big guy from DeMatha High School in Hyattsville, Maryland, Hawkeye Whitney, for pushing off. So Texas will inbound the ball with a 14-5 lead.
We had a foul very similar to that just before that, the recent timeout, and it was determined that that foul occurred before the shot.
Brent Boyd has come in the game now. As Texas moves that ball around the perimeter very quickly, Moore didn't have enough on the shot. Rebound carrying off, and here comes Whitney at 6'5". Getting the ball up court to Kenny Matthews, pulling up from 15 feet, and Matthews gets it down. It's now 14-7, Texas.
Matthews, perhaps the best pure shooter on the North Carolina State team. Very tough in transition when he pulls up for the short jumper.
North Carolina State continuing to pressure the ball. This is a good ball handler who had just get rid of the ball, John Moore. And here is Krivax. He'll put it up from 35 feet out. Look at him fire. He shoots 5 hours a day in the summer. Jim Krivax from Southport, Indiana, drills another field goal for the Longhorns, and they're up 16-7.
He's a pure shooter, but he also had 7 assists against Rutgers. A fine basketball player.
Whitney tries to take it to the basket, can't get it through the zone, so he goes over it, gets the field goal for North Carolina State.
There's the long pass again, the fly pattern, and two. Amazing.
4 field goals off the fly pattern, and 2 of those were subsequently fouled by free throws. Here's a foul call on John Moore. He's trying to set a pick, trying to block out. Art Jones ran into what they ruled it. Moore snuck in front of him.
That's one of those chicken fouls that I really don't like to see. North Carolina State has to change their press. Right now they're fronting the inbounds pass, which makes them vulnerable for the long pass. I expect them to see them put somebody back deep to protect.
Kenny Matthews gets the ball over to Hawkeye Whitney. Texas zone shifting in and out very quickly, playing the ball well as Craig Watts tries to get it down low. There's a hacking foul called on Texas.
With the matchup defense Texas employs, they make it very difficult to get the ball down inside. We're going to see just how intense they play the inside, because in this instance, North Carolina State makes the penetration underneath, the collapse, and the reach from behind. They just can't let that ball get inside to the big man. And they neutralized James Bailey, one of the top five centers in the country Sunday night.
They try to go to the alley-oop play inside to the big guy, Watts. North Carolina State has some big people.
Yeah, and they're just going to keep running them at him. Texas is just amazing. You look at them physically, and there's no way. But they are so smart, and they just don't miss the open shot. Abe Lemons underwhelms you with his coaching and his one-liners.
Keith Stevens has come in the game for the Texas Longhorns. And now Krivex outworks the rest and gets the basketball. 18-9 is the score. Texas has Krivex. Guns another one down. And Texas opens up its biggest advantage of the game, an 11-point lead, 20-9. We have 14:30 to play in the first half.
Krivex, a transfer from Auburn. His range is outstanding, almost an area code.
Austin. Clyde Austin, who is a very elusive player. He'll take it out to the top of the key. If there's anything open, he'll drive very quickly, as fast as anybody on the floor. That makes it a 20-11 game. Here comes Texas against the Carolina State press. Ron Baxter setting it. Looks for the men to move inside as they open up the lane now. Texas setting up a back door, and Krivex with an open lane going one-on-one. Can't get the layup to go, and here comes North Carolina State. Clyde the Glide Austin tries to take it around the corner on Stevens, and we're going to have the ball inbounds to North Carolina State.
Actually, there's only 1 point difference in these two teams. One is averaging 82, 183. But right now, North Carolina State very much has a transition tempo going, and that's to their advantage.
Hinder back in the game now outside, and Clyde Austin will set it up. Here is Don Perkins trying to take it in. Goes to Tony Warren, a 6'6 backcourt player from Raleigh, North Carolina. Rebound coming into side court, and Perkins hustles to the ball, and so North Carolina State with the offensive ball gets the another inside shot, but that time looked like Sir Pender was looking for the shot. There's Norm Sloan, the head coach of North Carolina State, a man who's been a coach of the year in three different college conferences.
This year has given him a lot of satisfaction. With 10 new players, his team was picked to finish last in the Atlantic Coast Conference. He drove them to a third-place finish and the title game here in the NIT.
Rebound comes down to North Carolina State. John Moore matched up against Clyde Austin. Donnie Perkins comes outside. Brannion staying back in the zone. He wants to play the defensive board. Lets him have the outside shot. Moore looks up court. Lead pass to Krivex. Krivex with a little too much on it. You won't see him miss many of those, or Texas as a team for that matter.
I didn't think they were ever going to make a mistake, and I do believe that State got a piece of that layup.
Kinder with a good shot, coming down low and then sprinting out away from the defense right into the heart of the zone and turning around, shooting over it. So it's now a 20-13 game. Another lead pass down court, and Ron Baxter slams it down.
Texas is putting a little screen down on the weak side, and they're picking off North Carolina State. And all they need is a one-step lead. The thing that's amazing is their passing. They've got to put more pressure on the ball because the passer for Texas is really able to sit back and pick his spots.
Baxter has now scored 9. Here's a good defensive board by Brannion. Up court it goes to Krivex. He's going to take it. Again, he cannot get it to go. Look at Baxter work. Rejected on the play by Watts, but it goes right to the little backline player for Texas, Krivex, who guns off the glass.
Nothing but cotton. Little angle off the board from Indianapolis, Indiana, a pure Indiana jump shooter. Shades of Rick Mount.
Baxter has 9, and Krivex has 8, and Perkins gets his first points of the night for the Wolfpack. They work a good play inside against the Texas zone. That makes it a 24-15 game. We have 11:44 left to play in the first half here at Madison Square Garden. This is the 41st championship game of the National Invitation Tournament. Krivex comes outside to Baxter. Texas sets up all different patterns. They work plays, and they'll catch you with looking the other way. Baxter with the tip. Gets good position, too. He's a glider inside.
Call him chubby, call him fat, but he can play.
Clyde Austin moving very nicely, switching hands on the dribble, takes it right through Texas and lays the ball in. So it is now 24-17 game. Texas basketball action will continue right after these words from your local stations.
You're looking at a couple of smart people who save regularly. Here's what's really smart about them. They're saving at the biggest bank in town. Their savings account is important in their financial relationship with their own personal banker. It helps them make the best deal whenever they need a loan. It helps give them access to experts in investments, trusts, and business services. It saves them time and money through automatic transfers from their checking account. In other words, they're making good use of the full services of a strong bank. These services are worth a lot of money, and no savings and loan, no credit union, no other Austin bank can deliver them as well as the 580 personal bankers in this building. Our point is this: you're better off at Austin National Bank.
Here is the Wolfpack leader, as North Carolina State right now has a problem. They've had one throughout the first half, have trailed by as many as 11 points to Texas. Right now, North Carolina State is down by 7, 11-16 to play in the first half. Texas inbounds the ball against the pressure defense full court of North Carolina State. And here is Krivak, 6'1 junior, who's already pumped down 8 points. A very confident shooter. He'll come and barely look at the basket, just fired up off the run a jumper. Outside to John Moore. This guy can handle the ball, Moore.
Very definitely, and so can Krivak. I think the tendency is to underestimate his ability to put it on the floor, go to the basket, and pass. Again, he had 7 assists against a good Rutgers defense.
Baxter gets inside for the shot, but can't get it to go. And now North Carolina State comes back down. If they can hit it here, they'll be back to within 5. Hinder takes it baseline. Not quite enough on the ball, but there's going to be a whistle and a foul call on Stevens of Texas that'll send Heine pinned to the free throw line for North Carolina State.
The Texas defense, again, is a matchup, but North Carolina State is able to penetrate. Now they're getting down inside. Little soft pass, Tiny Pender taking the ball in traffic. Yes, a good call, a foul. They're getting down in the color, which is where they want to go. Texas frequently will back off and make you prove the perimeter shot before they come out and play you honestly. And I think if North Carolina State can ever get a lead, with some limited time left, they're going to attempt to pull him out of that defense. Abe Lemon says he'll live and die with it. But if State has the ball and in control, they're going to want to look at man for man from Texas.
Kendall Tiny Pinder has trouble at the free throw line, and here comes Moore pulling up. He is blocked from behind by Art Jones of North Carolina State. And now the Wolfpack starts to run again. This guy can go with the ball. Austin inside. North Carolina State gets it to Perkins, fight for the rebound, and let's see, that's Warren coming down with it. Tony Warren, the 6'6 guard, coming off the play.
Again, the long pass. Warren was counting his field goal, and when he looked around, Johnny Moore was long gone. But for the first time tonight, the pass was overthrown.
It's quite apparent that Texas came in here with a game plan. They got pressed to send that wide receiver on the fly.
They're sure not afraid of the press. Some teams, when they're pressed, just attack it to get it over half court and set up their offense. Texas attacks it to the basket.
I'll tell you one thing, Texas is one of the most interesting teams you see.
Very definitely, but I think this pace is a little bit faster than they want to go. At the 10-minute mark, they have 24 points, and that's much too fast with their limited bench.
Austin takes a look outside the Texas zone, dancing around it now as North Carolina State is deploying people to either side of the lane. That is Tony Warren trying to jump. The little guard gets it without having to leave his feet. He's going to take it the distance. Hands off to John Moore, who lays it in off the glass. And now the Longhorns get the break to work after the last one misfired, and they're up by 7.
Good feed on the layup. They're always under control. They don't have great speed, but they're under control, particularly at the end of the break.
Art Jones back outside to Austin as the Texas zone was sagging, but Austin's shot was too far. Here comes Texas again. John Moore, lead to Baxter, loose the handle. It was last touched by Austin of North Carolina State, so Texas holds on to the basketball. We have a 26-19 score on the board. Texas in the lead from Madison Square Garden, New York. This is the 1978 NIT Basketball Championship Final.
It should start every morning, be comfortable, be economical. That's a smart buy.
You asked for it. The 78 Toyota Corolla two-door sedan. The smart money's on this Toyota. Sensational gas mileage that you wouldn't expect in anything so comfortable and smartly engineered, with a fully transistorized ignition for dependability. If you can find a better-built small car than Toyota, buy it.
Here's a car as smart as me.
You asked for it. You got it, Toyota.
Come on, come on, and have a Pepsi day. We're on the trail of something great. Today was made to celebrate. Come on, come on, and have a Pepsi day.
Pepsi day.
Used to be when I had a job to do around the house, it was one-on-one. Me against the house. And since the house was much bigger, I usually lost. Well, I've just changed all that with my new Black & Decker Workmate. It'll hold just about anything I want to work on, from a door to a pipe to a 200-pound dresser. In fact, my Workmate is so good at helping me work, I'm giving it Sunday off.
Workmate models available from about $40.
Back at Madison Square Garden in New York, we have 9:21 left to go in the first half of this 41st NIT championship game. With Bucky Waters and Howard David, this is Don Crickey at courtside at the Garden, as the Texas Longhorns with a 26-19 lead. About to get it to their big center, Gary Goodner, who'd not been in for some time.
A lot of great shooting going on here at the Garden, and at halftime we'll present on the Mizzlou Television Network the Pepsi Hot Shot Competition. Be sure and stay tuned for that.
John Moore tries to go inside. A lot of defense with him, can't get by. And here is Krivax out against little Craig Davis, who's back in the game for North Carolina State. A lot of people coming in and out on both sides. Been a very high-pressure game, a lot of intensity, a lot of running. Down with the rebound is Greg Watts. Coming up the court is Davis. And John Moore very wisely sets the stationary position, which Greg Davis didn't see, and we have a charge.
It's not a great defensive principle, because when you lose the ball in transition, the best thing to do is get back. John Moore gambled, made a stand, and he surprised Craig Davis. Craig, the only senior on this North Carolina State team. He knows better than that. He should have passed up the floor, not tried to beat him with the dribbling exhibition.
Tyrone Brannion gets the ball outside. We have a whistle down low, and apparently it's going to go against Texas. Offensive foul. That one goes against John Moore. He now has two. He also has 9 points. Krivax has eight. Baxter has nine. Leading point producer for North Carolina State is Pinder with six.
One of the reasons that Texas is able to run with their set defense is that the attack that North Carolina State is using many times gets four offensive players down inside that free throw line, and that leaves only that point guard back, and Texas is master at getting that ball out and deep.
Abe Lemons up, shouting out instructions to his center, Gary Goodner, who shouted something back. Now here is John Moore feeding off to Baxter, and Texas will set it up. Brannion, they're ready to fire at any time. They go right from the hip.
Absolutely. It's a misconception that they're a patient team. They're a confident team.
They are confident shooters. They take some real, seemingly low percentage shots, but seem to get them down. They lead right now 26-19, have led by as many as 11. This time, we have a foul call inside.
North Carolina State was down in the semifinals by 7 to a fine Georgetown team, and the same kind of sustained pressure just kept them in the game, and eventually in the second half they prevailed. Forcing that ball down inside, that time they actually beat the Texas defense back, and that is a great thing to do against the zone or the matchup. That kind of defense really needs time to get back, get settled, and point their men out.
Texas is now over the limit on team foul, so the bonus is in effect, but they can't get the front end, so it'll be Davis getting set to bring the ball inbounds, and Tony Warren, a 6'6 guard, gets it back out to Craig Davis, smallest player on the court at 5'8. Here's Warren. Hawkeye Whitney, that's his number, going up off that offensive board once and then twice, and then down it comes. A third try still is not good, but we're going to have a shooting foul for the Wolfpack.
For the first time, North Carolina State has shown their offensive rebounding ability. It's also good to see Tony Warren back out. He took a bad fall against Georgetown Sunday night, injured his lower back, but he looks fine.
Coming up this Sunday on many of these Mizzlou television stations, the East-West Coaches All-Star Basketball Game. Check your local listings for time and station. Butch Lee, Marquette, Gulf Ford, North Carolina, Ray Townsend, UCLA, just to mention a few.
That'll be 1 o'clock, New York time, this Sunday from St. Louis.
Right now we have Pinder, Kendall Tiny Pinder from Miami, Florida, knocking down those free throws, and all of a sudden we've got a basketball game as Texas, once with an 11-point lead, sees it cut to 5, 26-21 with 7:40 left to play in the first half.
But more than that, North Carolina State has played 10 men. Texas is going with an iron five.
Very good point, because it has been a pressure, intense game, lots of running. And Texas is probably going to take the pace way down unless they get that overmatch with the free man down court for the full court pass.
Trying to make the turn. John Krivak's a pretty good dribbler. Just didn't quite get around. The irony of the foul situation is that North Carolina State has been pressing all night. And here in the matchup, Texas is the first to reach the bonus.
North Carolina State staying with a man-to-man defense. Krivax has the ball hacked away from him by Craig Davis, but he can't make a play on it. And so it comes back inbounds to the Longhorns.
What a great effort by Craig Davis. Only 5'8". He looks so small out there with those big guys that if he used the whirlpool, he'd probably need a lifeguard. But he's all heart. And as we pointed out earlier, the only senior.
Krivax has the ball after a steal attempt by Pinder. He'd have had a breakaway had he been able to get a hand on the ball. Krivax looks behind big Ron Baxter, kicks it over to John Moore, and down low they go to Tyrone Branyon, who shoots just over the outstretched hands of Pinder and Whitney. And Tyrone Branyon gets his first points of the game and gives the Longhorns again a 7-point advantage, 28-21. Now Davis with a little bit of a mental error as he was looking down low but forgot to watch his feet. He traveled with the ball.
Again, coming up Sunday, the basketball coaches East-West All-Star Game from Kiel Auditorium in St. Louis, right here on the MISLU television network.
Krivax working in backcourt. Craig Davis playing him very loosely. Krivax will drive to the baseline and pump it up. He'll pump it up from right there. Get it that's down a, from right there.
That's a mismatch, Don. Craig Davis is a fine defensive player, but he's only 5'8", and with Krivax's range, he can go up a 28 right over Craig. Clyde Austin will probably be coming back in soon.
Whitney trying to follow it up, but he draws a foul on Texas as the call on the play is inside. We have a pushing foul signal. Branyon gets his second personal foul.
We'll have a chance to see that again. Over the shoulder, Texas trying to compensate for the fact that they're not as big and I think maybe just a little tired, flailing around in there, trying to keep that ball alive on the defensive board. They're not getting it out as quick, and I think the state personnel have begun to wear them down just a bit.
But Texas still has the lead. It's up to 9 again, 30-21, with 6.5 minutes to play in the first half. John Moore with excellent ball control, switching hands, looking to break that tight defense. Now Krivax. The Branyon, they're ready to fire at all times. Their percentages in the Sunday night win over Rutgers, 57%, running at 96 points. They're up around there in this game.
And Branyon, too, had 24 in that game for his season high. His last big game was against Houston, so he's a big game player.
32-21, and again, Texas has quietly, after seeing its lead cut to 5, upped it again to the biggest margin it's been in the game once before, 11 points. Branyon is rejected by Art Jones.
A super reject. He not only rejected it, but he got it to go off Texas, and it's North Carolina State's ball. Abe Lemons made a wise move with that recent timeout. He got the tempo back under control, gave his kids a breather. They look much better.
Abe can say something funny every time he opens his mouth. He says he now believes he's part Indian, like his grandfather told him, because every time he starts to dance, it starts to rain. But it's been raining for North Carolina State in this one. Here is a play again, the fifth time, and John Moore from Altoona, Pennsylvania, takes it the distance for the Longhorns, and they lead 34-23. Bucky?
If anything's going to bring rain, it's those long, high passes that are finding their target for layups. They're just destroying the state press. I think what State's going to have to do is take a man off the ball and put him back under their defensive basket. I think they can live with some jump shots in transition, but not give layups.
Matthews rims the hoop, and down the rebound is the big center Goodner from Denton, Texas. And now the Longhorns say, let's quarterback this team and play a control offense as the first half starts to wind down. 5:05 to play in it. Krivax letting it fly, and the big guy underneath, Sudhop, takes down the rebound. He is harassed, throws an errant pass, and it results in a North Carolina State turnover.
Glad Austin looking up the floor in his haste to find the open man, just lost the handle on it. And as you might expect, Texas, very alert, had it cut off. Norm Sloan upset with that one. He's a driving coach, as we pointed out early. Abe Lemons, a leisure suit, takes it easy. His kids have fun. Norm has pushed this team and driven them, and they've responded to it.
Boy, there's a basketball play. What a beautiful play as John Moore takes the lead pass and darts down the baseline of the court to lay it in and draw foul. Let's watch it.
Inbounds pass.
Oh, they're tough. I'm
caught him sleeping. John Moore, good move inside. He had 9 rebounds against Rutgers the other night. At 6'1", he's awfully strong. Perhaps the best athlete on the Texas team.
Texas can really play. They play a great team game. That was an inbounds play, and they just with a lead pass and a quick turn. Beat. for the North Carolina State defense to extend the lead to 36-23. 4:40 to go in the first half. Austin gets it down to Art Jones, a big guy. Cannot make it work, and Ron Baxter rips down the defensive board for the Longhorns, and now Texas again goes to John Moore, who will set it up and watch that clock wind down, looking for the percentage shot, although Texas' idea percentage shots can be 35 feet out. Here's the guy that can do it, Prevax, although he loses the ball here to the glider. Clyde Austin, lead pass to Art Jones, back to Austin, up he goes against Goodner, and there's a foul on Gary Goodner on the play, and sophomore Clyde Austin will shoot twice. But before he does, we're going to have a pause in the action with Texas in the lead, 36-23. Let's pause briefly for these messages. This is the 1978 NIT Basketball Championship.
I joined the move to Michelin.
I joined the move to Michelin.
I joined the move to Michelin.
You should, too. Michelin's the one that introduced the radio, and Michelin makes only radios. Michelin's the one that's made radios longer than anybody else in the world. Michelin's the one to insist on.
Join the move to Michelin.
For real tire satisfaction, think Michelin first. We're second to none.
Company! Dismiss!
Well, the training's rough, you know, the sergeant's tough. Now it's all behind, got blue ribbon on my mind.
I've got Pabst Blue Ribbon on my mind. More and more lately I find I've got a taste for living. I'm thinking cold blue ribbon. I've got Pabst Blue Ribbon on my mind.
Naturally good Pabst. A lot to look forward to.
We are back at Madison Square Garden in New York. We have 4 minutes and 16 seconds to play in the first half of this 41st NIT championship game. Texas opened up quickly with full court passes. They were beating the North Carolina State defense for breakaway layups. Their lead was up to 11. Then it was cut to 5. And now it is 12 points as Clyde Austin is at the free throw line for North Carolina State.
He took a pretty good whack. Gary Goodner, the only starter for Texas that's from Texas, really gave him one of the hook'em horns. He rang old Clyde's bell, but he hit the free throw.
Gave him the full hook.
Yep.
Brannion now against the North Carolina State press. Gets it up court to Ron Baxter. Fred Akers might run him at fullback.
Darryl Royal's here. He's probably licking his chops.
Lead pass goes down low, and up with the ball is Ron Baxter. He's so smooth. He's a power guy getting up in the air and busting open a defense, and then he's got that beautiful touch.
All he did the other night was go 8 for 9, 6 assists, and 2 steals.
That'll
pretty
keep
good
you in the
for
lineup.
A chubby guy,
yeah,
huh?
Keep you in the lineup. Here we go. Goodner takes it down, goes to Baxter. It's a 38-25 game. Texas with a 13-point advantage. That's the biggest they've had in this game. Prevax will put it up from the hotel, as Abe Lemon says.
Beautiful. A beautiful shooter. And he can put it on the floor. You can't get too close.
Prevax now has scored 12 for the Longhorns. Here is Pinder with a nice shot off the baseline of the floor for North Carolina State. It's 40-27. Texas maintains its big advantage. They got two guys bumping out here, and official Ed Gattata calls one of them for it. He's going to call Texas Gary Goodner for it.
State is nestling up. Texas trying to get that step to get free. Some bad vibes out there, Donald. But they're getting down. State is really coming down and getting in their shirt. And Texas, although they handle the ball very well on the press, they are not a physical team. Abe Lemon said, if they let them play, we're in big trouble. And State loves the physical game.
Abe once had a guy at Pan American that scored 1 point in the game and was mouthing off in the locker room afterwards. And he went over to him and said, son, all you did tonight scoring 1 point was score one more than the dead man could. That's all you did for us. He was at Pan American, or Oklahoma City, rather, for 18 years, and then at Pan American for 3 years. Now he's in his second year at Texas in their big new arena. They average 14,000 people a game. Used to be down there, as you were saying, Bucky, they didn't know whether you blew up a basketball or stuffed it, but the Southwest Conference, always great for football, is becoming a great basketball conference.
For sure. Arkansas in the Final Four of the NCAA. Texas here playing for the NIT Championship. And, of course, Houston made the NCAA, lost to Notre Dame in the first round. And we had a great game last year, Don, with Houston of the Southwest playing against St. Bonaventure. Otis Birdsong. It was a 94-91 game, and the Bonnies won it on the strength of Greg Sanders' 40-point performance. They are playing basketball in the Southwest, believe it.
Krivac, who comes into the game averaging 21.5. He's probably going to come out of this as the leading scorer in this NIT and an almost sure bet to make the all-tournament team. Krivac puts down another one. He now has scored 14 points to lead all scorers. Here comes Donnie Perkins back in the game for North Carolina State. And Hawkeye Whitney, number 43, is back in. The big power forward from that famous basketball high school outside Washington, DeMatha.
Following that point, the Southwest Conference has two. The Atlantic Coast Conference has two. There are only six teams still playing in the Final Four of the NCAA.
Excuse me, Bucket. They got Whitney from behind, tipped it away. Baxter did. Now he goes to Krivac off the glass. He can't get it to go. We're going to be a foul call. Looks like Krivac is charging. They got him. Holding his position nicely was Perkins of North Carolina State. So Krivac calls the foul.
Coming up next Sunday on the MISLU Television Network's telecast of the East-West Coaches All-Star Game, we'll have the All-America Black and Decker squad. And that is a tremendous unit, Bucky. We won't reveal who they are, but if the folks tune in at halftime of the East-West game next Sunday, they'll find out who the five are.
Can hardly wait, Howard.
Going to the free throw line now is Tony Warren, backcourt for North Carolina State. As North Carolina State is down at this point 42-29 in this championship game of the NIT, coming to you live from Madison Square Garden in New York. A lot of scouts here from colleges all over the country. Pro scouts, everybody in here to look at this one. It's been a tremendous success with the regionalized concept. It'll draw somewhere in the neighborhood of 162 or 3,000 for the tournament when you consider all the games played everywhere.
Unquestionably, the most successful NIT ever. The new format has been well received.
Krivac coming off the baseline, shoots right in the face. In your face for Krivac, and he draws a foul on the play. Krivac now with 16 points in the game and going to the free throw line. Clyde Austin drew the foul, was charged with a foul.
Jim Krivac is the only one of the top 50 scorers in the country that is still playing. You know, we talk about the team concept in basketball. In the NCAA and NIT, only six of the top 50 scorers eventually made those two tournaments. He is the only one left, and that speaks well, I think, for team basketball.
That's very interesting. A lot of times, guys can do everything with a ball but play with four other guys. Here's the tip out going to John Moore, who takes it up court for Texas. They are in the lead by 14, 45-31, with 2:25 left to play in the first half. Back outside to Krivac. Krivac, very confident with the basketball, fires it off on the flank to John Moore, can't get that jump shot to go, and here comes Carolina State with a two-on-one break. Lead goes to Warren. And Tony Warren with the assist from Craig Davis gets the bucket for the Wolfpack.
A picture break. The little guy, Craig Davis, in the middle. Probably should have slowed up at the free throw line. I believe Texas could have drawn the charge, but he gave the good head fake, a Class A move, and a good bounce pass.
Krivac throws the ball now over to Tony Warren, out to Krivac again, and the long shot is rebounded nicely off the offensive board by Brannion. Getting real rough inside, and Texas is on the long end. They're getting it.
Ron Baxter again on that offensive board. Yeah. It's very physical. The thing Abe Lemons feared most was letting him play. Watch this action, sticking it right back up the nostrils, and on top of that, he goes to the line. He's hurting people in there. If he's 205, I don't believe it.
Well, he admits to 225, but Abe Lemons says, well, might be somewhere between 225 and 250. He was 225, but he is a player. Ron Baxter doing the big job for Texas so far in the game, has scored 14. And now, nicely done inside. Warren getting the bucket to make it a 48-35 game. Again, the lead goes down court. Texas does it again all night long.
Texas, the master of the counterattack. You blink your eyes, you turn your head, they nail you. They pass the ball extremely well, and they're so offensive-minded and so confident. They just attack you. They're always looking to score from 84 feet right down to the boxes.
That was Brannion on the payoff end of the long lead pass. Watts has the ball hacked away from him. The ball will come back inbounds to North Carolina State. They're in white, Texas in the burnt orange.
Right now, Norm Sloan has to hope that the constant shuffling of personnel and the continued pressure will wear Texas down. But right now, they haven't even broken a sweat.
Hard work inside. Gets the bucket for North Carolina State. And now we have Krivac
Taking it back up court. Whitney with 6 points after that last field goal. We're inside a minute to go in the first half. 45 to play, 50-37 Texas, and the Longhorns with the ball. Goodner, who's been very quiet on offense, those are his first two.
Yeah, he's the only boy from Texas. About time he did something. At least that's what Abe's yelling at him.
Gary Goodner, that puts the lead up to 15 again. And again, Prevac takes the ball, Moore's ahead of everybody, and Texas, with masterful team basketball, has opened up a 54-37 lead.
What we're seeing is a second clinic. This is just a replay of what they did against Rutgers on Sunday night.
That was Tony Warren firing from the outside. Here is a shot as the game almost winds down in the first half and finally does. Texas 54, North Carolina 39. That's the end of the first half of the 1978 NIT basketball finals, with Texas in the lead by 15.
You know, I really believe our new Toyota Celicas deserve to be the import car of the year.
I couldn't agree more.
You asked for it. Motor Trend Magazine's 1978 Import Car of the Year. The new Toyota Celicas, the car of the 80s.
Celica won this award in competition with some of the best cars in the world.
For its styling, which is an aerodynamic work of art. The interior comfort and decor, and the quality control of its construction.
And the road test that scored big for Toyota Celica in acceleration, braking, precise handling, and fuel economy.
I am so happy.
Don't cry.
The new Toyota Celicas have earned the right to be Motor Trend Magazine's Import Car of the Year for 78. If you can find a better built small car than this Toyota, buy it. Congratulations, Toyota.
You asked for it. You got it, Toyota. You got it, Toyota. You got it, Toyota.
I'm going to keep on doing that till I get it right. Yeah, I work hard and I play hard, and I use STP gas treatment. You just pump it in your tank and it goes to work cleaning your carburetor. I take good care of my wheels on account of I'm cheap. I bet you are too. Try it. Whoops. Try it.
Let's pause for local station identification. This is Television Sports USA, the MISLU Television Network.
It took a lot of hard work to start this business and a couple of lucky breaks to get it going. But now, for a variety of reasons, it's paying off. Like my Austin Savings ACT account. Last year's average deposits of $30,000 earned me more than $1,500, money I wouldn't have earned otherwise. Enough for me and my wife to take a vacation in London this year. She thinks it's romantic. Actually, it's just good business.
Austin Savings. We're the largest because we work harder for more people.
Live mannequins model bright spring fashions daily between 3 and 7 as we color it spring at North Cross Mall.
The most important part of any car is the brake system. It's also the most neglected. Many people unknowingly drive cars with brakes that are dangerously unsafe. At Brake Check, we will professionally check your brakes absolutely free. That means you're under no obligation whatsoever. If a brake problem is discovered, and if you'd like us to do the work, you can be sure of a fair price and that we'll do the job right. Stop in to have your brakes checked. You'll like our price. It's free.
This is Channel 7, KTBC-TV in Austin.
Head coach Norm Sloan. It's been a run 'em up and down the court, shoot 'em up contest thus far, and thus far it's Texas, which has canned about 12 or 14 layups thus far. The fast break has been working, and they've been breaking the press and playing very well. While there are ceremonies going on here at halftime of the Garden, and there, Fred Gruninger, the athletic director of Rutgers University, to the left of your screen, Larry Gerasciotti of the NIT committee and athletic director at Wagner, is in the middle there. They're making a presentation of botany jackets to those gentlemen. That's Darryl Royal, the athletic director at the University of Texas. Willis Casey, the athletic director at North Carolina State, is being acknowledged. He's just committee your picture.
And the athletic director of Georgetown.
And the athletic director of Georgetown,
is Frank Rienzo, who will be the final man into your picture. All right, standing by in MISLU television control is Don Tollefson with this report on the Pepsi Hot Shots.
Thank you, gentlemen. I hope those of you who have enjoyed the first half of the NIT Finals will also enjoy our halftime feature. And I think you will, because it is a tribute to the kids. And I know as a sports fan myself, I love watching youngsters play sports because they do it for the pure fun involved. Our halftime tribute is brought to you by Pepsi. Have a Pepsi Day. Right now, without further ado, let's take a look at our tribute to the future basketball stars of America.
Hot shot! Show us what you got!
Last year, the Pepsi-Cola Company and the National Basketball Association joined together in a unique venture called Pepsi NBA Hot Shot. And today, millions of youngsters are benefiting from this dynamic program. As you can see, our Hot Shot contestants do much more than just shoot baskets. Here at last year's quarterfinals in New Orleans, these aspiring Dr. J's and Pistol Pete's are having the time of their lives. They're meeting the stars, they're making friends from all over, and they're involved in a learning experience that goes far beyond basketball. These youngsters are the cream of the crop. They advanced through highly competitive tournaments held in NBA cities, and they came to the Superdome in New Orleans to show off their skills. We'll see those in just a moment, but before we get to that, let me point out that the real beauty of the Pepsi NBA Hot Shot competition is that all the kids benefit. No matter how far a youngster advances, he or she is learning about healthy competition, hard work, and physical fitness. And most importantly, they're having a lot of fun. This program deserves an awful lot of credit for being a real investment in our youth. The objective in Hot Shot is to score as many points as you can in 1 minute. Special Hot Shot theme music times the competition. Starting at half court, a youngster shoots baskets from 5 hot spots on a basketball court. There are different point values ranging from 2 to 5 points, and each hot spot depends on the distance and the angle. Bonus points are awarded if a player attempts shots from all 5 hot spots, regardless of whether or not he or she makes the basket. There are 2 layup points allowed worth 2 points each. 1 point is subtracted for each dribbling or motion violation. As you can see, they had the preliminary competition before an NBA game. There was a sparse crowd, just the parents on hand, but everything was building towards the excitement which would come later that evening, when at halftime of an NBA basketball game, these hotshot youngsters would have an opportunity to compete. The hotshot competition is fierce, but it is friendly, and that is something that the NBA and Pepsi stress. They want these youngsters to really be aware of good sportsmanship because they know it's something that can be applied to each and everything the youngsters do. Right now, let's continue our visit way down yonder in New Orleans. These are the NBA stars, players like Pistol Pete Maravich and all the rest. But right now, let's take another look at stars of a different age group, the Pepsi Hot Shot Kids. Pepsi Hot Shot's actually run by more than 1,200 separate youth organizations, ranging from small church groups to major city recreation departments, like those in New York City and Los Angeles. Hot Shot is open to both boys and girls anywhere in the country, 9 to 18 years old, who are not varsity players. The names of the ultimate Hot Shot winners are enshrined in the NBA Hall of Fame. But here's the important news. Awards are made to each and every youngster in the program, from playground certificates to distinctive trophies for the national winners. Look for Pepsi NBA Hot Shot information at your local Department of Recreation or other youth service organization this summer. And right now, let's take a close look at the competition with the actual music they compete to.
Show us what you got.
We'll be right back. Once again, that address for more information on the Pepsi Cola Hot Shot program, Pepsi Cola Hot Shot, Purchase, New York, 10577, and you'll get this very, very informative booklet, which will help your youngster get involved. I think at this point, all of us should agree that it is the kids, after all, who make it worthwhile. You know, we have more basketball excitement coming up for you on the Ms. Lou Television Network. Next weekend, from St. Louis, we're going to have the Coaches East-West All-Star Game, and a couple of guys on the squads are going to be Butch Lee and Phil Fort, two definite basketball superstars. That'll be coming to you on many of these Ms. Lou stations. We are going to be rejoining Don Crickey, Bucky Waters, and Howard David at Madison Square Garden for the NIT Finals. But first, let's have a word from Pepsi Cola.
Zonk, if you want a date, get in shape.
Shape? I'm solid steel.
Chic shape, Zonk. Chic shape.
Get clean, get close, get comfort too. Get your face in chic shape.
Click in Chic Super 2, the only twin blades Teflon coated for incredibly comfortable close shaves.
Great shape, Zonk.
That's chic shape.
That's Super 2.
Well, back at Madison Square Garden in New York, halftime, 54-39, the Longhorns of Texas lead the Wolfpack of North Carolina State. I'm Howard David, along with Bob Perlstein, the vice president of SFM Media Services, the advertising agency for Fram. Bob, I don't want to talk to you. We can talk anytime. I'd rather talk to the client at this moment. And he's Ted Graham, who's the zone manager for the Fram Automotive Division. Ted, we're delighted to have you with us at halftime of the NIT, the 41st NIT.
The people
that are watching right now see you holding a trophy, which we might want to hold up a little bit higher. This is the middle of the Fram trophy that will be presented to the player giving the outstanding performance, both offensively, rebounding, and overall floor play. We might want to talk more about the Fram trophy itself.
Well, Howard, this trophy has been in existence for 7 years. It's been awarded to such notable people in the sports world as O.J. Simpson, Kyle Rote Jr., and such celebrities as King Olaf of Norway, just to name a few.
All right, Ted, why has Fram gotten so heavily involved in sports?
Well, Howard, our company, like this country, we're depending upon the youth of America for our future, as is the whole country. And we want to recognize the youth of America with this trophy, which has been given to these other famous people.
Right, how long has Fram been involved, in sports and in presenting awards?
Well, we've been involved in sports to various degrees for many years. This particular trophy has been around for 7 years, Howard.
Ted Graham, we're delighted to have you with us at halftime to make the presentation of the Outstanding Performance Award and the Fram Award, and we hope you enjoy the second half of tonight's game.
Thanks very much.
Ted Graham, the zone manager of Fram Automotive Division. Bob Perlstein, the vice president of SFM Media Services, the agency for Fram Automotive. We'll have more halftime activities following these brief messages from our local stations.
What makes KVET, one of America's great radio stations, the best country music in the world? Outstanding personalities. Jim Travis, Arlie Duff, Sammy Allred, Penny Reeves, Jerry K. Green, Mark Jones, and Lydia Anderson. One of the state's best news departments with Jim Ribble and sports with Larry Carlson. Austin's only radio professional weather staff anchored by James C. Fiddler. Just some of the reasons why the 24-hour country giant, KVET, is truly one of America's great radio stations.
You didn't sign on with the best firm in town because you wanted a free ride. If your work's not done at quitting time, you stay until it's finished. Okay, so your golf game's not as good as some of the other guys you work with. But then, you're not going to wait 20 years to get your name on the door. You expect more from yourself and the people you do business with. We know. We're your bank. Citibank.
It's a whole new world of magic. It's the new Ice Capades, a dazzling jubilee of fun and color.
Ice Capades.
Beauty in motion, dramatic illusions.
Magic.
Great family entertainment.
Ice Capades.
The Ice Capades come to Austin April 13th to 16th for six performances at the UT Special Events Center. Call 471-7733 for information.
The score at halftime of the 41st National Invitational Basketball Tournament is Texas 54 and North Carolina State 39. Stay tuned for the second half of the 1978 National Invitational Basketball Championship Finals.
Well, the game was tied, but luck was on our side. Now it's all behind. Got blue ribbon on my mind.
I've got Pabst Blue Ribbon on my mind. More and more lately I find I've got a taste for living. I'm thinking cold blue ribbon. I've got Pabst Blue Ribbon on my mind.
Naturally good Pabst. A lot to look forward to.
At Fram, we've taken what we've learned about babies like these and designed a super air filter for cars. Inside a normal car filter, outside an extra filter. In tests, compared to our normal single air filter, the Fram with the extra filter lasted 50% longer. So we call it the Fram Extra Life. Why not put one in? It costs no more, and it saves a lot later.
Fram and Autolite are Bendix companies.
The second half of tonight's NIT Basketball Championship is brought to you by Pepsi-Cola and your local Pepsi-Cola bottler. Have a Pepsi Day. Toyota, the official car of the NIT Basketball Championship, hopes you're enjoying today's game. You ask for it, you got it, Toyota. Fram, makers of oil, air, and fuel filters, windshield wipers, and Autolite spark plugs. And by Pabst Blue Ribbon Beer, naturally brewed Pabst, a lot to look forward to. Turtle Wax, the world's largest selling liquid car wax. New improved hard shell formula, cleans, polishes, protects in one easy operation. Turtle Wax, with a hard shell finish. Soothing, refreshing Cepacol is called the professional mouthwash, used by more physicians and more is used by hospitals than any other brand.
For spring 78, let Botany 500 tailor your wardrobe. American style. From our Chase, Bentley, and Cartier collection.
We are back at Madison Square Garden in New York. This is the 41st NIT Championship game. Don Crickey with Bucky Waters, Howard David as the Texas Longhorns. And there is the man who has put the game plan together that has worked so well, Abe Lemons. Blocked up by one of his big guys, Coach Lemons, with a team that came in 25-5, has opened up a 15-point halftime lead. And, Bucky, what can North Carolina State do to get back in this?
Well, I think North Carolina State is going to stay with their pressure. They're going to have to change the way they're doing it. Obviously, the fronting man for man has burned them. Some kind of a zone trap, either pulling the man off the outlet man, the inbounds man, or just dropping one back. As I said earlier, I think they can live with some jump shots off transition, but they can't give layup.
Pinder started to come on late in the first half. He has 12. Warren, you see, with 10. Hawkeye Whitney, he usually gets more, has 6. Austin with 6. And for the Texas Longhorns, they've been led by their backcourt player, Krivax, who has 14, and by Baxter up front with 14. And John Moore, who had the ball so much in the first half, opens up the second half with it. Gets it down low to Brannion. If he wasn't fouled, nobody's ever been, but no whistle. Brannion, Abe Lemons is up. Jumping up and down.
That's pretty close to a rain dance, Don.
And Moore was the highest scorer in the first half with 15 for the Longhorns. And the ball comes back in to Texas. Ron Baxter will put it in play. Here it is. Home run ball over the head like Willie Mays, Tyrone Brannion. But Pinder, Kendall Tiny Pinder, puts a full whack on the ball.
It looks like Norm Sloan is going to challenge him to keep making that pass. Tiny Pinder just drilled it.
Well, from what we see, I guarantee you Texas will keep making it.
The long pass. Tiny Pinder coming from behind. Make sure there's no easy layup.
Over and back. Krivax, we're told, has now officially totaled 17 points for the Texas Longhorns. So he is the top point producer with his backline mate Moore with 15. Texas in the lead 54-39. We're early in the second half. With the ball on the outside is Clyde the Glide Austin, who throws up somewhat of a hope. Doesn't get it to go, but Sudhop, the 7'2" center, is in the middle as we have a whistle. Sudhop gets the foul call against him.
One of the amazing stats from the first half is that Texas is only shooting 50%. It just seemed like they were shooting 85 or 90. The key for them is only four turnovers, whereas North Carolina State had 13. Rebounds were basically even.
Here's Krivax on the outside. Texas setting wide to either lane, side of the lane. Big, strong men. They'll pick off as the guards come by, and here's Krivax. Oh, he's some sweet shooter.
They're coming out smoking again. Absolutely.
So now we have a 54-39 score on the board. I believe it's 56-39. They haven't changed yet. 18:50 left to play in the second half. As here is a tip away by Moore. Lead man is Krivax ahead of the pack, and he goes down, puts it up, despite the best efforts of Tony Warren to come from off the play.
Again, State in attacking that defense. North Carolina State is getting down inside and leaving the top of the key exposed. And if you make a mistake, Texas takes it right to the basket.
So Texas now has its biggest lead, a 19-point advantage. Texas 58, North Carolina State 39. We have a foul on the play. Ron Baxter getting set to bring the ball inbounds. Got no hand in the air as to who was pushing off. But Texas has the ball. And here comes Krivax as Austin tries to pressure him. The Texas Longhorns in this championship game lead 58-39. They were up at the half 54-39.
A three-pronged attack for Texas at the half. Baxter with 14, Goodner with 17, and Krivax with 15.
Krivax working off a pick set for him by Goodner. Can't get it to go inside. Outside to Brannion. Texas keeps 5 men in the game. Everybody handles the ball. And there is Ron Baxter, who just amazes you. It looks like he came in from the Nautilus machine or something.
Listen to this for our first half. He's 6-for-10 from the floor, 2-for-2. Look at the arc on this shot, over the outstretched hand. He also had 8 rebounds and 5 assists. He's worth a full scholarship.
Coming back down the floor the other way, Whitney got the bucket. Whitney got the bucket, so it's now 60-41, Texas over North Carolina State. Hawkeye Whitney with 8 points for the Wolfpack. Brannion pulls up for a free shot, does not have enough on it. A fight for the ball, and the most remarkable, the most amazing, Ron Baxter from Dorsey High School in Los Angeles. The Texas sophomore has pumped in 18 points as Texas has blown open the game, leading by 21, 62-41.
North Carolina State has their work cut out for them, obviously, and there's no thought of holding up by Texas. The tempo is still up.
Look at that pass. Moore leading Krivax. No bucket, but a foul on the play. Great hand coordination as Moore so dealt it off.
Penetrating in deep, a little bit out of control. The penetration was out of control, and there's Texas taking it the other way in a hurry.
Krivax firing again. He's lucky he's playing in his own schoolyard. He's very relaxed in the garden. A lot of teams get tight in here coming in. Reject by Sudhop, but we have a foul call on the play.
Second time around, he missed it the first time, but Sudhop came back and labeled some people. Very frustrated. North Carolina State's very frustrated right now. They just can't get the ball to go down, and every time they miss, Texas runs the ball down their throat. Amazing transition team.
Abe Lemons, in all his years in coaching, has played in a lot of tournaments. He says, what you call yourself when you're the host, playing the host team in a tournament, the victim. And here is Goodner at the free throw line.
We just had a second shot of Glenn Sudhop drilling that ball into the upper deck. Against Marquette in December, the toughest and biggest loss suffered by Texas. They lost at Marquette by 9, and only to South Carolina on the road by 1, to Arkansas on the road by 4, Baylor by 2, Houston by 2. Nobody's beaten them badly.
As you mentioned, they have a victory over Arkansas to their credit this season. Here is Austin driving the lane. Let's see what the call is inside. It looks like it's going to be a foul call on Brannion, who is trying to draw position before they'll Ball is put back into play. We're going to have a timeout. Texas 64, North Carolina State 41. From Madison Square Garden in New York City, this is the 1978 NIT Basketball Championship Finals.
When we first came to Timber Country, they called us Homelight. But we came away the Chainsaw King. And the quality that earned us that name is all right here in the Homelight XL. And you can buy the XL right now for only $84.95. That's a $15 savings. Or invest in one of seven other home lights and get a $15 woodcutter's kit free. Our name is Homelight, and we are the Chainsaw King.
What do you want for graduation? A car?
Uh-huh.
What I want is a really smart truck.
You asked for it. A 78 Toyota SR5 long bed sport truck. It's smart any way you look at it. Out back, a bed as big as a stage, 7 long feet. Inside, a cab like a pad with wall-to-wall room. And looks, Toyota's at the head of any class. If you can find a better-built truck than Toyota, buy it.
You asked for it, you got it, Toyota.
To get 30 tons of logs off a mountain, you get to know a little about fear and a lot about ice and snow and rain and hairpin turns. And in the end, you get to know about Miller time. Time to head for the best-tasting beer you can find. America's quality beer, Miller High Life.
If you've got the time, we've got the beer, Miller Beer.
Lyde Austin at the free throw line for North Carolina State, a team that you'll recall in 1974 won it all, the NCAA championship, led by the great David Thompson, their head coach Norm Sloan, now in his 12th year. He came to North Carolina State from the University of Florida in 1966. Long lead pass down court, and the only guy there to get the ball is the glider, Clyde Austin.
One of the few misfires on the bomb.
There's no outlet man, no wide receiver. I was running a turn-in. Here he is, Pinder, gunning it down low to Tony Warren, muscling his way inside. Warren does very nicely to get the ball up and down. Here's the lead pass, goes to Moore, and there's a foul on the play. It was prior to the shot. The basket is negated. John Moore thought it was an intentional foul, which, of course, under NCAA rules, is two shots if it's called.
And that's a good rule, but actually Clyde Austin lost his balance and really didn't try to cut him down. He just kind of moved into him. The amazing thing is that Texas is beating North Carolina State at their own game, that being the full 94 feet in the transition game. They don't look like they can do it, but believe me, they've done it two nights in a row, and I'm a believer.
What you just saw was a shot of the Toyota Coaches Award. We will be presented to the winning coach, and right now with Texas ahead by 19, it appears that Abe Lemons might be toting it home to Texas. John Moore takes his time, goes one-on-one against Tony Warren. Warren with a big height advantage. He's a 6'6". Moore is a 6'1", but he's so quick. Down low they go to Baxter. This is his game, but he can't get it off as he's hacked before he spins in for the shot. It is 64-45. Texas in the lead with 15:55 left to play in the 41st NIT championship game. Bucky?
Gary Goodner is taking Glenn Sudhoff, the 7-2 center for North Carolina State, outside. A smart move by Abe Lemons. Glenn Sudhoff, like most 7'2 guys, isn't very effective far away from the basket. By pulling him out, they open it up, and they're sliding Ron Baxter inside. And when he gets the ball in close, he's devastating.
Baxter, as you see, with 18.8 on the average in this tournament. And Baxter, so far, has scored 19 in this game, so he's over his season average. He's not done yet with 15:45 to play. Baxter with the rebound, throws it out to John Moore, and Texas with that 20-point lead. It's been as many as 21. Elects to slow it down now, and I think that Texas is going to only run if there's a three-on-one overmatch or that elusive wide receiver loose again, and he's been 8 times down court.
I don't know. I believe they're just going to turn him loose and let him go. I don't expect them
play.
To start think about tempo for a long, long time yet.
Whitney starts in. Whitney can knock somebody down, 6'5", 225. He did knock down Tyrone Brannion, but it was not judiciously chosen, that move by Whitney. It's a foul on him as Brannion had position.
North Carolina State has 15 minutes, 20 points. With the capabilities of these two teams, it can change around. North Carolina State has got to take each possession very seriously. They can't come down and try to catch up and two or three times down the floor. They've got to score each time down the floor and tighten their defense. Hawkeye was out of control that time. Smart. Notice from Texas, no one up there trying to block a shot. They just slid over from the weak side, maintained good position, took the charge.
And so it's a 65-45 game. Texas is in the lead. We have 15:09 to play. There are 16 fouls already accrued for North Carolina State here in the second half. Only one on a Texas team. So the bonus is going to be a big factor in Texas' favor very shortly. Driving to the basket is Gary Goodner, and he gets all of it. Goes right around Sudhop.
With Texas spreading North Carolina State out, it's very difficult for Glenn Sudhop. That time he was driven around from 25 feet from the basket. I expect North Carolina State's going to have to go with some smaller people. They're being spread all over. It's no place for the big guy.
There's no question they've got to get more speed, more agility in their offense and defense. And now, as Prevax, who certainly has those qualities, goes to the basket. His shot is rejected, but there's a foul on the play. And Prevax goes to the free throw line.
Hey, Blemons, pointing it out. Coming from the weak side, oh my, yeah, he got a bunch that time. State, again, very frustrated. The Wolfpack can't get anything going, but they're making sure that there aren't any three-point play opportunities. They are taking the layups away.
So Krivax with his next shot, if he hits it, will be the leading scorer in the NIT. Dern of Georgetown ended up with 88 points throughout play. Rutgers won the consolation game earlier this evening, defeating Georgetown for third place, and now we have Texas in the lead 69-45 over North Carolina State as Norm Sloan, the head coach of the Wolfpack, starts to send in new combinations. Art Jones is back in the game, as is Kenny Matthews. Donnie Perkins is back in with Craig Davis. And we have Craig Watts in at center. He's a seven-footer. In and out, rebound taken down by Perkins. Too much on the shot, and Brannion with good position takes the defensive board for Texas, and the Longhorns come up court again.
In control. Texas totally in control right now.
They were threatened only once. After building up an 11-point lead early in the first half, North Carolina State came back to trail by five, but then Texas opened it up. At the half, they had the big 15-point advantage, and now it is up to 24 with 13:55 to play. Baxter puts it up. No basket. No basket. He traveled.
Still a beautiful play. He did shuffle a feet. It was a good call. But ladies and gentlemen, it's another clinic. Don't be deceived by the fact that Texas is spreading out the offense. They're going to keep trying to score. Abe Lemon's teams have always put points on the board.
Kenny Matthews coming in to fire it down for North Carolina State. That makes it 69-47 Texas. And North Carolina State goes into a semi-press. They tried an all-out press at the outset of the game. And as you were with us, you recall they were burned so badly with those full court length passes that resulted in easy layups for the Texas team. Now, with Texas in the lead, 69-47, more basketball action follows right after these messages from your local stations.
When you're hungry for a burrito supreme, really hungry for a taco, you know what I mean. Got a craving for a enchilada or two. Want a beefy dough starter? Here's what you do. What you say? We all go down to Taco Bell today and hit with Taco, 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 Taco Bell. Taco, 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 Taco Bell.
Come and let me show you a house that's made for you, a home with a lovely fireplace, a restful porch swing too, a window to let the sun in, a place when the kids are grown. Let Eden take you to this place, let Eden take you home.
Eden Real Estate, marketing fine new homes and already established homes. So when you're ready to buy your new home,
let Eden take you home.
Eden Realtors, 12701 Research Boulevard.
There you have it. There are some horns and some Razorbacks. Southwest Conference coming up in basketball, having a big evening here tonight at Madison Square Garden with 13:35 left to play in this 41st NIT championship game. Gary Goodner goes to the free throw line for Texas, looking to annex the Longhorns' lead to 23 or 4 if he can make the first in the other end. Nope. The bonus already in effect for Texas with a lot of time to go. Firing in desperation is Perkins from the corner. Donnie Perkins can't hit it for North Carolina State. And now Texas is going to kind of frustrate North Carolina State.
It's like the mongoose and the cobra now, just very patiently moving that ball, waiting for their opportunity. State has got to come and force the action. and that's very dangerous against a smart, very well-coached Texas team.
And we have a foul call here going against Watts of North Carolina State for pushing off, so Goodner is right back at the free throw line.
Watts and Sudhoff, the two big men for State, have just had a difficult time. The pace of this game, the transition, the fact that when Texas has the ball, they're spreading State all over the floor. It's been a long night for big guys.
Here comes a little guy of the ball. Craig Davis moves it up quickly to Kenny Matthews. Davis looking for something to open up inside. Texas stays with that shifting zone, mostly a 2-3. They overplay the ball very nicely. It's tough to get it off to the weak side away from the ball and get an open man. John Moore has too much on the pass, and he goes into row A.
Some arm. Baxter can throw it.
He can sing it the length of the floor with one quick flip. He looks like catcher the way he guns that ball down court.
That outlet pass of his, he could throw it through a car wash and not get the ball wet. I mean, he can steam it.
The big guy, Baxter. One of the reporters asked Dave Lemons after the semifinal win, is Baxter's playing overweight? And he said, hey, Baxter, you fat? And Baxter just laughed. Here comes Krivax. Off to Tyrone Brennan. No go. And way up is Perkins. That's Skyer. A little bit of David Thompson.
Yeah, he's got to go a long way. He jumps like David, but David was some kind of player.
Still is.
Yes, he is.
69-49, a 20-point lead for Texas with 12:07 left to go in this championship game of the NIT. John Moore is harassed and fouled by Craig Davis.
Well, I may be waving a flag falsely, but 12 minutes and 20 points is still possible, but State has to get it together quick. The big rebound. Craig Davis trying to come in from behind. Actually, he was in a very precarious position because he really wasn't in a position to get back on defense to stop the break. So he gambled, reached in, and fouled. This North Carolina State team was picked to finish last in their league. They had 10 new players at the start of the year. And Norm Sloan has taken his team and driven them and pushed them to a third-place finish in the Atlantic Coast Conference, which, countering the Southwest Conference, they also have two teams in the playoffs. Duke is in the NCAA Final Four, and, of course, North Carolina State here. But Norm's done a great job. Both of these teams are going to be heard from in the future.
North Carolina State all underclassmen, and now, except for Craig Davis, the man with the ball, their lone senior, he tries to get it inside to Watts, and we're going to have a jump ball, apparently. That'll stop the clock with 11:50 left to play in the game, and Texas holding to the big lead, 71-49. Well, look at that again.
Little guy underneath. Wow, tremendous contact, no call, and it's a loose ball. Craig Davis had his bell rung. He was hurt at the end of the year. A very courageous little guy, dies for the loose balls, has had some shoulder problems. He's still not afraid to go down in there.
Have a jump ball. Brannion is 6'7", and Davis is working with about a foot less.
Look out for the long one.
Yeah, that's right. Right off the tip, it might go. Yeah. Yep. Davis won the tap.
You're going to tell me Craig Davis tipped it back, right?
And he gets it down. Boy, Davis can cover some ground, though. He skitters over that court like a water bug, but North Carolina State needs a whole lot at this point with 11 and a half minutes to go in this NIT championship game, trailing Texas by 20, 71-51. Brannion can't get it to work. Tip try by Goodner's no good, and now North Carolina State starts to move. Lead pass to Kenny Matthews. And all of a sudden, the Wolfpack starts to look good.
Showtime, Don. Greg Davis threw that ball behind his back 25 feet. Here we're going to get a chance to see it. Right behind John Moore, right on the money. Ease up and in. State's moving. They got just a little momentum now. Texas obviously slowing it down a little bit when they got control.
Craig Davis in there playing his heart out. He's a senior from Rockville, Maryland. But now Texas comes right back as Baxter hits for his 20th and 21st points.
The little State rally really upset Texas, didn't it? Came right back down for another layup.
And it's 73-53. Texas in the lead. And here comes the Longhorns. John Moore leads the way at 2-on-2 break. Davis goes down, and the ball is dished off to Tyrone Brannion, who led his junior college team in Southern California to a JC championship before going to Texas. And now, with the score 75-53, this is the 1978 NIT Basketball Championship Finals. The Madison Square Garden.
Come on!
Come on!
Why?
Come on, come on, come on and taste the fancy way. Come on, come on, come on and have a fancy day. You're on the trail of something great. Today was made to celebrate. Come on, come on and have a Pepsi day.
A Pepsi generation.
When an ordinary air filter gets really dirty, it can eat gas and kill your acceleration. Now, this is the Fram Extra Life. It's got a special outer filter which helps keep the inner filter clean.
Which means that the Fram lasts 50% longer than our ordinary single filter. 50% longer. Why not change your old filter for a new Fram Extra Life? Doesn't cost any more, but it can save a lot later.
Fram and Autolite are Bendix companies.
This smelly onion and Scope showed something new about fighting bad breath to these users of the leading antiseptic.
Scope mouthwash in this dish, and I'm going to ask you each to smell this onion.
Smells kind of mini.
Your mouthwash with the other half of this onion, what's it smell like to you?
A medicine-y smell.
Scope smells good.
If it can make onion smell this good, imagine what it can do for your breath.
Scope fights bad breath. Scope doesn't give medicine breath.
This is Don Crickey with Bucky Waters and Howard David back at Madison Square Garden in New York, and a big one coming up.
Big one comes up on Sunday, Don and Bucky, the East-West Coaches All-Star Basketball Game at Kiel Auditorium in St. Louis. Be sure and tune in on many of these MISLU television network stations.
Austin gets the ball over to Pinder, who takes a look and now throws it back to Whitney. Austin goes down low, and Whitney, who hasn't been in there much in the second half, makes a nice turnaround shot for North Carolina State. And they trail again by 20. Texas 75, North Carolina State 55. And Texas hurries it down court, and they go to their quarterback, John Moore.
State still pressing, head up man for man. There has been no change all day.
John Moore trying to go to the basket, can't get it to work. John Moore had the ball rejected, and Hawkeye Whitney picks it up. Gets it back out to Clyde Austin, the sophomore from Richmond, Virginia. He went to the same high school as Arthur Ashe and football linebacker Willie Lanier. Maggie Walker high in Richmond. Now it's 75-55 with 9:30 left to play in the game, and Texas still holding to the lead. They've had it throughout, never been behind.
The call there was not goaltending. The call is a technical foul for slapping the backboard, causing it to vibrate. Here's the shot from the side. He really didn't touch the ball or interfere with it, but he hit the board sufficiently hard to cause it to vibrate. It's a technical foul. Hank Nichols makes the call. Abe Lemons is not believing.
Abe was here in New York, and he said the most amazing thing was when he ordered breakfast the first day. He ordered two eggs that were $4.95. He said, asked the waiter if he couldn't go back and meet that chicken. He said he'd never heard of a chicken that could lay that valuable an egg. Said he went back there, and the chicken was sitting under a little parasol, had a little bed for it, very proud.
He's out of sight. He's been on the other end of this. In 1968, his team was losing by 19 at half against Duke. He would not let them go downstairs. And in the NIT in Madison Square Garden, made his team stay up between the halves and scrimmage each other, skins and shirts. It didn't help. Duke beat them by 20.
Clyde Austin knocks it down, and it is a 75-58 game, so North Carolina State comes back to within 17 points. Long lead pass to Tyrone Branyan, but North Carolina State gets two men back. Cut it off.
It's like Branyan's tired of laying it up. Actually, the big guy, Watts, got back very well that time, forcing the high trajectory.
North Carolina State, of course, has turned out some great NBA players. It is 77-58, Texas in the lead, 8:47 to play in the game. Last year, the Atlantic Coast Conference scoring leader, Kenny Carr, was North Carolina State. Now at the Los Angeles Lakers, David Thompson, the great Denver Nugget. And now it's 12 points up for Whitney. Looking at the other point totals, Pinder has 13 for the Wolfpack. Austin has 10, Warren has 12. Back the other way in a travel.
The truck and trailer got loose coming down the middle. Ron Baxter got away with it a little bit, going too fast. And I really think he walked because he was trying to wedge in there and try to fake for that three-point play. Notice how he protects the ball extremely well. He did everything right except he shuffled the feet a little bit.
And he comes right back, Baxter does, and rejects the ball underneath. That ball does draw a crowd down underneath. 8:16 to play in the game. Texas 77, North Carolina State 60. At the half, Texas had a 15-point lead, 54-39. So we're going to jump it up. Kendall Pinder will jump against Gary Goodner, two of the biggest people on the court. North Carolina State in white. Victimized by the full court pass of Texas in the first half that resulted in five breakaway baskets. They've subsequently been able to shut down that long pass for the most part here in the second half, but the damage was done early, and North Carolina State so far has not been able to come back. There is a big follow-up play. We'll have to see if they credit with that. They give that to Pinder, or to Whitney, who now has 14. Whitner and Pidney both way up there. And it is Whitney who is credited with his 13th and 14th point. Here's another foul bucket.
North Carolina State can score points in a hurry. Not as quickly as we've seen Texas the last two nights, but they can score. And with 8 minutes and a 15-point spread, which could go to more right now with more at the line, State still has a chance, but they've got to take more advantage of every offensive opportunity.
Tony Warren with his fourth personal foul, and Moore at the free throw line getting his 18th and looking for his 19th point of the game. And Texas annexes its lead now. It is 79-62 with 7:55 left to play in the game. Championship game of the 41st NIT. Zero. Kendall Pinder gets it down. Nicely done. The 6'8 front man from Miami. There is a long lead pass down court to Tyrone Brannion, and we have a reject by Art Jones. A clean reject.
Great hustle by Art Jones, but again, a good pass. Right on the money. Goodner nails his man. Only great hustle by Jones coming from the back. But still, State is unable to force the turnover, unable to force Texas into mistakes. They're still dictating.
Baxter will put it in play with Texas in the lead now by 15. Their lead was 24 at one point in the second half. Texas lead cut to 79-64. 15-point advantage at the moment. 7.5 to go. Baxter, so very elusive at the offensive end, darting in and out despite his great size, and he now has 23 points.
Extremely quick.
Whitney fires up and hits for the Wolfpack. So Hawkeye Whitney does his job. He has 16. He started to come on. Had 6 in the first half. And it's 81-66 Texas. We're winding down to 7 minutes left to play. Texas with a control game now, taking their time, and they are working the clock at this point.
Number 11, Jim Krivacs, is a true shooting guard, but he can handle and he can give it up, as he just demonstrated. Probably handles more than any other high-scoring guard I've seen in a long time.
So, we'll pause briefly for these messages from your local stations.
A beautiful home is only beautiful with wall and floor furnishings from Accent Flooring. In carpeting, Accent Flooring has every color, design, and length at competitive prices. For kitchens or bathrooms, Accent Flooring has vinyl or tile to brighten up a room or tone it down. For your walls at home or the office, Accent Flooring has infinite possibilities with an interior decorator to guide you. Accent your home. Consult the decorating experts at Accent Flooring.
For a limited time only, courtesy Dodge is discounting America's number one selling van, Dodge Vans. Drastic reductions that will make this number one seller a number one buy. Discounts up to $2,500 on selected vans and other tremendous discounts on their entire inventory of new vans. The largest inventory in Central Texas. Over 150 vans to choose from, including the Santana, Tradesman, Sportsman, and even a selection of custom vans, or courtesy Dodge will have one customized for you. No dealers, please, because this sale won't last long. At these discounts, the vans won't last long. Courtesy Dodge, 7309 North Interregional.
Superior execution of the give and go. Jim Krivacs to John Moore underneath. Tony Warren, who was beaten, had to reach in from the back and foul. It was his fifth.
Krivacs from Southport High School outside Indianapolis was the most valuable player in the Derby Classic for high school players in Louisville after his senior year. As you mentioned, he went to Auburn at the outset and transferred to Texas. And here is John Moore at the free throw line from Altoona, Pennsylvania, 6'1" junior. He is the one of the third leading scorer in Texas history now. And now as we come down to the other end, we have a pushing foul underneath. Kenny Matthews and Tyrone Brannion were pushing off. Let's see what they have. Brannion gets the call against him, and so North Carolina State will inbound the ball. They do to the open side to Art Jones. Not quite enough there, but Whitney not only taps it in, he slams it in.
I think the officials missed that one. The ball was still on the cylinder. Not only did they touch the ball on the cylinder, it even hung on the rim a little bit.
It makes it 84-68 Texas with a 16-point advantage, 6:25 to play.
Texas very patient, still spreading out, no hurry.
But they're always looking as they bring the North Carolina State defense out to go back door, to go down low, and that underneath opens up. There's Tyrone Brannion. He's darting back and forth across the baseline.
State has left their seven-footers now and has gone to a smaller, quicker team.
There you go. Here comes Mr. Baxter. And the rebound to Whitney, kicks it out quickly to Austin, who takes it down court and feeds off in the corner to Kenny Matthews. In the middle, John Moore of Texas intercepts the ball, and the Longhorns come back the other way. Down to Krivex. So sweet.
That's the kind of shot you're looking to take with an 18-point lead and 5.5 minutes to go. Most coaches would have died of a heart attack, and Abe Lemons was up cheering.
Like a 9-iron. It takes a while to come down from Krivex. He has 25 points, and Texas is in the lead, 86-68. Sophomore Clyde Austin will inbound the ball now for the Wolfpack of North Carolina State. Gets it to Matthews. North Carolina State very much in need of quick shooting and accurate shooting now as time is becoming a factor and working against them. There's one to make it 86-70 Texas. Score on the play by Pinder by Austin gives him 12. Tyrone Brannion takes a shot and he gets the roll. So Texas come right back and get it. Tyrone Brannion has now scored 12 points for the Longhorns.
Some touch. He went 12 for 16 in the semifinals too. They all shoot the ball well, and they're a very unselfish team.
Game starting to open up now. We're having a shootout, and here's that long one to John Moore. He's got Matthews between himself and the basket. Feeds to Krivex. Right on time, all night long. So it is now an 18-point advantage for Texas, 90-72, as we're down to 4:35 left to play in the game. Back the other way, Clyde Austin and gets the roll for the Wolfpack to make it 90-74 Texas. Krivex all the way. He is so tough. Krivex with 27. 29 now for Krivex. North Carolina State wants a timeout. 92-74 Texas to Madison Square Garden, New York City. This is the NIT Championship Final.
We're the Van Arsdale, Tom and Dick. We're identical twins. And we drink identical beers. Light beer from Miller. We love it. The best thing about light beer is it's less taste. Filling.
Great taste.
Less filling. It's got a third less calories than the regular beer.
Great taste, Tom.
Less filling. And I'm not Tom. You are.
Well, I'm Dick.
You think you are.
You always
but you never
call.
Were.
Light beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer and less.
You know, I really believe our new Toyota Celicas deserve to be the import car of the year.
I couldn't agree more.
Ask for it. Motor Trend Magazine's Import Car of the Year for 78, the new Toyota Celicas. Celica won against some of the world's best.
Because of its styling, quality, comfort, acceleration, braking, handling,
fuel economy, and ride. Congratulations, Toyota.
You ask for it, you got a Toyota.
Jim Krivex on the breakaway, and the guy that's trying to catch him is Clyde Austin, who's a burner himself. Krivex is not just a jump shooter. He has shown us everything a basketball player can do. An impressive performance.
He is a player, Jim Krivex. The first game score for third place, Rutgers 85, Georgetown 72, if you join us late. Here is Craig Davis, who sparked North Carolina State earlier, making it 92-76 Texas, with 4:05 to play in the game. North Carolina State, with time working against them now, pressures the ball, but John Moore very deftly brings it down the court between the legs, behind the back. And we're getting Moore now for pushing off as the game starts to get a little bit rough. An offensive foul signaled against John Moore.
In the stall pattern Texas is using, they're trying to screen down on the weak side, and that time Hank Nichols called an illegal screen. It was a good call.
You're talking about Abe Lemons losing big when it happened to him in the past. Said he's got speeches for being 20 points down, speeches for 10, but once he was down by 33 and didn't have a speech bag, just left the locker room. And now, North Carolina State with Perkins hitting for his fourth point, makes it 92-78. 14-point advantage, North Carolina State slowly inching back. They've been down by as many as 24 in the second half.
They've got to move awfully quick, Don. They've got to take some chances, and they've got to do some fouling. And that's going to be tough because Texas is one of the top 10 free throw shooting teams in the country.
As Krivac drives, Craig Davis grabbed him, and they ruled it. Davis got him on the arm.
Krivac, pressure, taking the ball in on the little guy. Craig Davis reaches in, tries to steal it. Foul is called. Good call. Usually, if you're going to reach in, it's better to reach from down up. As soon as you come in over the top, the officials almost automatically blow that whistle.
Krivac has 30 as he closes in on 100 points for this 1978 NIT. 31 for Jim Krivac of Texas, and the Longhorns have a 94-78 lead, and we have 3:15 left to play. Davis fires and knocks it down for the Wolfpack. Davis has now scored 8 points for North Carolina State. Krivac ahead of the pack. Davis, despite his best efforts, cannot catch up, and Jim Krivac takes it a distance.
North Carolina State persists in playing them head-to-head, and Texas persists in carving them with a deep pass down the floor. They've got to put somebody back to stop the layup, force some jump shooting.
Kendall Pinder working hard down at the other end for North Carolina State. 19 points, a lead pass goes to Tyrone Brannion. Coming up is Krivac, feeds to Brannion. And Texas has put on a demonstration of team basketball that has been absolutely magnificent.
Incredible. That's why they're a good basketball team. Sure, Krivac is having a great night, might even be going for a record, but he gave it back to his teammate. Such a class.
98-82 is the score. Texas with 2:29 left to play. We have a foul call that's going to bring the ball down to the other end of the floor. The foul call is against Watts, his third. Watts of Texas gets his third personal foul. Or Watts is going to be against Brannion going to the free throw line. So Watts of North Carolina State. Greg Watts. Here is Pinder getting the ball out quickly now, and coming up court with the ball is Clyde Austin, looking to lose his man with the dribble. Feeds it off nicely. Watts cannot control. And it comes back inbounds to the Wolfpack.
Well, the Pack, you have to give them credit. The Wolfpack is still trying, still pushing the ball up the floor in the face of another flawless performance. You look at Texas in the semifinals and the finals in the NIT, and you have to say, who beat these guys? Well, Southern Cal did it in the opening game by one, Marquette by nine at Marquette, Arkansas by four, Baylor by two, Houston by two in the tournament to get into the NCAA. They are for real, and they are so young. Only one senior started this game, that being Goodner, the boy from Denton, Texas. So both of these teams are going to be heard from. And the experience here, even for North Carolina State, if they can't pull this game out with their young squad, will pay dividends in the future.
Pinder with the shot now has 21 points for North Carolina State. And it is an 98-86 game. And here's another bucket up quickly. Very well done, Whitney, to make it 98-86. So all of a sudden, with 2:02 left to go, North Carolina State rallies back to within 12. From Madison Square Garden in New York City, this is the 1978 NIT Basketball Championship Finals.
No one leaves this locker room till I find out who's been using my safeguard. Bob, your deodorant soap hasn't even been opened.
Oh, what are you going to do, sue me? I want all that safeguard protection.
Damn.
Man, I'm a sucker for lather, and safeguard's deodorant lather is different.
For lather and protection, people love Safeguard so much, it's always the smallest soap in the house.
Larry, since we all love lather and protection, next week, bring a bigger bar of Safeguard.
90. There is Norm Sloan. His team was down by 24 in the second half of this NIT championship game. They have rallied back to within 12 with the Texas Longhorns in the lead, 98-86, but time is so much a factor now with just 2:02 left to play. While we have a moment, we'd like to credit some people who've done a great job with its NIT, a tournament that was really threatened a few years ago. People like Pete Carlissimo, the president of the National Invitation Tournament Committee, Ken Norton, Dan Quilty, Larry Gerasciotti, John Kaiser, and Scotty Whitelaw.
The NIT having its most successful run at regional sites and then into Madison Square Garden for the semifinals and tonight's final game. John Moore going down low against Kenny Matthews, and they kick the ball back out as Texas opens it up now. They want to run that clock down with North Carolina State starting to mount a threat, but time working against them.
There are plenty of teams to choose from for the National Invitation Tournament. There were 54 Division I teams in the NCAA that won 20 games or more. Only 36 of those got in the NCAA or the NIT. 18 teams that won 20 games didn't go to a tournament. So the quality and the balance of basketball is super, and another layup.
Baxter breaks it. Baxter gets ahead of the field on an overmatch as the Carolina State defense had to come out, slams it down, and is fouled on the play.
Smart. Baxter rolling down, seeing nothing but blue paint, goes up for the stuff. It's amazing he gets it up and down the way he does.
I'd like to also thank our very fine producer-director, Bill Schwing, for his good work. And our statistician, Saul Widener. We have 121 left to play. It is Texas 101, North Carolina State 86. Texas goes back, sets up in that zone. They like that zone.
Well, they do a lot of cute things off of it. They force you to stand around. They force you to shoot from the outside. Their opponents have only shot 43% against them all year from the floor. There has to be a reason for that. On top of that, because they have so much confidence in that back line, they make so many steals, and they have the good, quick hands to do it.
Whitney, with that last field goal, now has 20 points, and Abe Lemon brings his Longhorn frontliners off the floor, including Krivac, who has scored a total of 33 points in this game. Abe Lemons en route to an NIT championship. And a very big night for Texas basketball. His assistant coach, Barry Dowd, also over there with him.
Don, Krivac has got 99 points for the tournament, which is far below the record for a four-game venture. Bobby Lloyd, 1967 for Rutgers, scored 129 points in four games. Krivac has had a big night, but still has a way to go for the all-time record.
That one looks like it'll stand a while. Lloyd, that's... Well, here are some most valuable players being selected. We have co-MVPs, as you'll be seeing shortly, and very understandably, they come from Texas, and they are Ron Baxter and Jim Krivac sharing the MVP honor.
Well, I'm glad we didn't have to choose between them. Both outstanding performances. They complement each other so well, but then this whole Texas team does. They are very, very unselfish. Plus being talented, well coached.
Montgomery is now in the game for North Carolina State as Texas goes to its backup troops. Clyde Austin firing it down. In the game for Texas now we have John Carsey in. Also in the game is Phil Stroud. Coming in is Mike Murphy. It is 101-90 with 40 seconds to play. Texas is in the lead.
Abe Lemon still not relaxed. He's up cheering, directing traffic.
Mike Murphy comes in the game for the Longhorns. They have the luxury now of going to their bench. Also in the game for Texas is Tom Nichols and Ovi Dotson. Go to the bench in a championship game. It's a pretty nice feeling as Texas, with a brilliant team game, leads 101-90 as we wind down the 1978 NIT championship game. Last year, in the final game, it was St. Bonaventure beating Houston, you'll recall. The last time we had a 100-point game was a long time ago. That was in Maryland, beat Niagara 100-69 in 1972. 13 seconds to play. To 101-90 is the score, and there is Abe Lemon. He's got something to be real proud of now as Clyde Austin goes to the free throw line.
The Pack is still hustling, still fighting. There just isn't enough time. They had a clinic put on them tonight, but they were beaten by a fine basketball team.
Hawkeye Whitney still working hard despite the fact they cannot come back now. 1 second left to go, and there is the horn. And the final score is in. That's the end of the 1978 NIT Basketball Champions with the final score. Texas 101, North Carolina State 93. We'll be back at Madison Square Garden in a moment.
Pete, how do you spell relief? When I get acid indigestion, I spell relief, R-O-L-A.
Whoa, I have gas.
I spelled the same for gas, R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
Rolaid spells relief. In this test with Rolaid's active ingredient, laboratory acid changes color to prove Rolaid's consumes 47 times its weight in excess stomach acid.
Now, how do you spell relief?
R-O-L-A-I-D-S.
For acid indigestion and gas, Rolaid spells relief.
You know, we sure could use a real smart car.
Yeah, a good looker that's a dependable worker.
You asked for it. The 78 Toyota Corolla SR5 Liftback. A smart combination of sensational styling and practical engineering that won't wipe out your nest egg. Toyota Corolla, a smart way to build a car. If you can find a better built small car than Toyota, buy it.
Buy smart, I always say.
You asked for it, you got it, Toyota.
All right, final score, 101-93. The Longhorns of Texas defeat North Carolina State. It's only the second time. Last time was 72 when a team scored 100 points in the final for the victory. And only the second time in the history of the tournament that they have been co-MVP winners. Baxter and Krivax of Texas. Jim Krivax, congratulations, super tournament.
Thank you. We play well as a team. We moved the ball well and it did it all for us tonight.
Ron Baxter, muscled your way inside. They say you're 205. I think it's probably maybe 2 1/4, eh?
Yeah, that's about what it is. You know, it's preseason. I picked this up all during the season. But I feel good. You know, we played, beat a hell of a team in North Carolina State. They're one of the best. You know, we played all year, and we just rose to the occasion. I think you should give them a lot of credit also. And I say hello to my cousin Mike in San Francisco. I talked to him this morning.
Ron, I think maybe we can start saying that Texas is now a football and basketball power.
Yeah, listen, we've been trying to prove the whole year. Same thing with the whole conference, with Arkansas and ourselves in Houston. I think we finally proved something now.
Congratulations to both of you.
Thank you.
Okay, Ted Graham from Fram Automotive Division. You must be a very interested spectator here in the middle of this crowd. Our co-winners, Ron Baxter, Jim Krivax for the Fram Award. And let's just get this up so we can get plain sight of the award. I know that Fram is very happy to make this presentation. We're delighted again to have you with us.
Absolutely. And if these fellas think they'd like to sell spark plugs and oil filters, we'd like to have them come and see us when they're through school.
Well, that's the story so far as the presentations are concerned. Let's go back to Don Crickey and Bucky Waters for a final recap.
All right, thank you, Howard. The final number is in, and Texas, with the big first half lead, the brilliant team play, a 101-93 victor over North Carolina State. Carolina State didn't quit. They fought back, but time ran out. And Texas is a very deserving champion, Bucky.
State came in playing their best, and that's press and run. And the thing about it, that you just have to give Texas a tremendous amount of credit. I've seen them press two nights in a row by two good basketball teams. They never lost their poise, and they just got layup after layup. That's coaching, and that's discipline.
Now for Bucky Waters and Howard David, this is Don Crickey. Good night from Madison Square Garden in New York. Texas, the victor.
You have just seen the championship game of the 41st National...